In this video, I will show you how to move from this situation, where you point the telescope and you see nothing but stars, to this one, where the frustrations become all good feelings. And to do that, you only need a telescope with tracking, an astro camera and a laptop. Then follow the steps I'm going to show you now, and you will find any object in the sky super fast. Download and install the ASCOM platform. Link at the description. Open Sharpcap and go to Settings. Go to the Hardware tab. Select Telescope Simulator for .NET. Click on Apply and OK. Open again the settings. Go to Plate Solving tab. Select Sync Mount Only. You have to do these steps only once. Increase star detection noise threshold to 200. This value can be different depending on your skies. If it does not work, try another number by trial and error. Apply and OK. Sharpcap is connected. Open Stellarium, go to Configuration window, choose Plugins. Go to Telescope Control. Click on Load at Startup and then Configure. I have my telescope, but yours will be empty. Click on Add Telescope, which is this button. Choose ASCOM. Name your telescope as you wish. Then close the windows. Now you will have a new icon here with a telescope. From now on, every time you open Stellarium and want to use this feature, just click on the icon, select your telescope and connect. Easy and simple. Then, zooming out, you will see the brown icon of the virtual telescope. Now, the action. The brown circle is the virtual telescope, and the gray circle, it's simply where I pointed my mouse. A very faint nebula I choose for this demonstration. Now open ASCOM. I use Alt and Tab to open that window. Then just use up and down, left and right to take the brown circle to match the place you wanna go. It's enough to be near, you don't have to be precise. When you connected your virtual telescope in Stellarium, automatically opened the ASCOM. Just open that little window and work. You have Sharpcap, Stellarium, and this little window with ASCOM always open. At this time, your real telescope is outside pointing to nowhere. So it's time to manually point the telescope more or less to the place we wanna go. Again, you don't have to be precise. According to Robin from Sharpcap, as long as you are within 15 degrees is enough, which represents more or less the distance of 4 Telerad circles. Open Sharpcap and click on this icon. Sharpcap is now plate solving, trying to detect where my telescope is pointing. Look how fast it works. Then click yes and go to Stellarium. Look at the brown circle. It moved to where my Dobsonian is really pointing. But what I want is to go to the gray circle, which is the place where is my faint nebula. And now I know that I have to manually move my Dobsonian outside to the left and then up a bit. So I go outside and manually move the Dobsonian, hoping to get the target. After that, I open Sharpcap. However, as the nebula is so faint, I can't see in the screen if it's there or not. So what I do is to do again the plate solve. Click on the button, Sharpcap is plate solving again, and look how fast it is. Incredible, love it. Done, yes, again to Stellarium, and almost there. The rectangle represents my camera. But look, on Sharpcap, we almost see nothing. We have to trust. So I go outside, I move again the telescope a bit up, just a bit now, and let's just confirm with another plate solving. Should be here. Sometimes Sharpcap plate solve without asking to confirm. The bar turns green. And that's it. On the target. No question about that. Let's live stack. I will choose 8 second exposure. It's there already, I can see it. It's there. Fear not, because you will have many opportunities, because I will always work like this, and in my live streams you will see it always. Look at this incredible final image. It's very grateful to watch the skies like this. That's why you should click on one of these videos on the screen if you want to level up your Dobsonian performance. Worth it. Oh boy, it's worth it. Like the video and thank you very much for watching.